So very good morning, one and all. I am Dr. Ravi Kumar, working as associate professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering. So the coordinator of the program. And I would like to say welcome you all for this inaugural program. So first of all, let me invite the dignitaries onto the dais. Respected Director Professor N.V. Raman Rao Garu, the chief guest of this program. We are welcoming you, sir, for this inaugural function. And Professor A. Kumar, Head Department of Mechanical Engineering. Professor L. Krishnanan and Dr. M. Manjaya, the other coordinators of this FDP. My dear colleagues and my dear participants, say a warm welcome to you all for this inaugural function of a 1 week online AICT Atal FDP on 3D printing and design, an advanced level course on advanced medical applications of 3D printing during this December 14 to 18, organized by the Department of Mechanical Engineering. So before we start this program, let me invite the head of the department, Professor A. Kumar sir, to brief the department and departmental activities. So it is over to you, sir. Kumar sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Ravi. Respected Director sir, Professor N. V. Raman Rao, coordinators of the AICT Atal Online FDP on Advanced Medical Applications of 3D Printing, Professor L. Krishnanan, Dr. Y. Ravikumar, Dr. M. Manjaya, and participants from this workshop, a very good morning to you all. So it's my pleasure to introduce the department profile. The Department of Mechanical Engineering was established in the year 1959. The department presently offers one undergraduate program and seven M.Tech programs, namely Thermal Engineering, Manufacturing Engineering, Computer Integrated Manufacturing, Machine Design, Automobile Engineering, Materials and System Engineering Design, Additive Manufacturing, and PhD programs. At present, the department has 48 faculty members with research expertise in different specializations of mechanical engineering. The department has good research facilities for both experimental as well as simulation-based research. The department has a liaison with reputed industries and R&D organizations such as Non-Ferrous Technology Development Center, Hyderabad, Defense Metallurgical Research Laboratory, Defense Research Development Laboratory, ARCA, BHEL, and CPRI, etc. All the faculty of the department are actively engaged in R&D and consultancy. Presently, the department is handling about 30 funded projects with a worth of rupees more than 4 crores. The department has recently acquired metal 3D printer at a cost of 1.4 crores under TechUp 3 grants. The institute is establishing Siemens Center of Excellence in Digital Twin Industry 4.0 in manufacturing, in which the department is playing key role in the execution of the project. The department produces a large number of publications and offers solutions to the industry regularly, and is also active with the regular outreach activities like workshops, FDPs, conferences, and international conferences. The department has been recognized as a QAP center for M.Tech and PhD programs. The department has laboratories with state-of-art equipment like a six-axis milling machine, thermal IR camera, a variable compression ratio engine, friction stir welding machine, 3D printers, and solar PV, solar thermal flat plate and parabolic with the tracking system, and a vibration exciter, etc. The department placement records are very high, with the B.Tech students having above 90% placement every year. Our M.Tech students are also highly employable to significant high placement percentage for all the specializations. The highest pay package in the year is close to 25 lakhs per annum, and the average is around 10 lakhs per annum. Companies like Tata Motors, GE, Alstom, ABB, L&T, Rolls-Royce, Intel, Godrej, and to name few, come for on-campus recruitments. So with this, I can also congratulate the coordinators of the Atal FDP program on advanced medical applications of 3D printing. So with this FDP program, the participants may have acquired knowledge in medical applications, the medical devices which are produced through 3D printing process. So 3D printing is now a very manufacturing solutions for not only engineering applications, also medical applications. So with this, I can conclude my speech and over to Dr. Y. Ravikumar.
Thank you, Professor A. Kumar Garu, for giving the overview of the Mechanical Engineering Department. So now I'm going to give a brief on the workshop. So that is the AICT 1 week Atal FDP. So coming to 3D printing and NIT Warangal. So as HOD already mentioned that we had a very close association with this technology, say for the past 15 years. So we at NIT Warangal, so we took the initiation first time in India to start a PG program with the specialization MTech in additive manufacturing in collaboration with Central Manufacturing Technology Institute, CMTI, Bangalore. We launched this program from the academic year 2014-15 onwards. And coming to the skill development in this area, so we have been conducting several FDPs, and around 1,000 participants we are trained in this area of 3D printing, rapid prototyping and additive manufacturing. So by conducting around 13 workshops, so over the period of 10 to 11 years. And recently, we have equipped with a metal 3D printing facility, as the head of the department has announced. And very few educational institutions having this facility. And we are very much thankful to our beloved director to sanction this facility and encouraging us to do a cutting edge research in the area of 3D printing. And coming to the Atal FDPs, so AICT normally sanctions maximum of 5 programs per an institute. So NIT Warangal has backed all 5. So this is the one workshop we are organizing now on 3D printing and design. So in an advanced level, so last week we have completed the 3D printing elementary level workshop. So, and these are the two plus one another robotics and mechatronics area we have conducted 1 month ago. So these are 3 workshops from the mechanical engineering department. So we organized 3 and say we have a 2 more workshops already completed by the electrical department. So that is about the 5 FDPs that has been sanctioned to NIT Warangal during this academic year. And coming to the number of participants, so we had around 140 registrations, and we approved only around 100 eligible participants from all parts of the country. And actually, this proposal we submitted to AICT to conduct face-to-face mode, but they have converted this as an online, so because of this pandemic. And we planned differently, more on the emphasis on the hands-on practice for this workshop. But anyway, we'll do our level best to say bridge that gap, even though it is online, like by adopting certain open source softwares, where we have planned to do 3 to 4 say hands-on sessions. So that is through open source softwares we have planned. And coming to the content of this workshop, during this 5 days, over 14 sessions, so we are going to cover the topics like say medical scanning technologies for 3D printing, that is both invasive and non-invasive kind of technologies we are going to cover. And medical image processing softwares for 3D printing, both commercial as well as open
source. Hello, how are you? Yeah, I'm good. I was on tour all these days.
And we have...
Orissa. I was in Orissa.
Design and development of medical implants and devices. That is another topic we are going to cover. Recent advances in 3D printing processes. Advanced medical applications of 3D printing in diagnostic and surgical models. Designing and developing tools, guides, implants, prosthetics, and surgical devices. And also related technologies like health monitoring devices, rehabilitation and aided devices, assistive devices, dentistry, cosmetic surgeries, sports technology, drug delivery, and finally tissue engineering and organ printing. So this is what we are going to cover over the 14 sessions as planned, and hands-on sessions planned on 3D medical modeling using open source software tools, preparation of build setup files using open source softwares, and fabrication of medical models on both polymer and metal 3D printers. So that is my live demo. We are going to demonstrate these facilities here to fabricate these medical devices. And we have eminent speakers from the, this is basically an interdisciplinary kind of nature of the workshop. So say our collaborators means which we have been working with the hospital people, the surgeons especially. So they're coming and they're going to deliver the sessions during these 5 days. So we have eminent surgeons. So we have Dr. M.V. Reddy, orthopedician from Sunshine Hospitals, Hyderabad. And we have Dr. Chitra Chakravarti, madam, orthodontic surgeon from Navodaya Dental College and Hospitals, Raichur, Karnataka. And we have Dr. Aditya Mohan, oral maxillofacial surgeon from MVR Dental College, Sangareddy. And we have speakers from IIT Hyderabad. So we have Dr. Falguni Pathi, the associate professor in Department of Biomedical Engineering from IIT Hyderabad. And we have a couple of, industry people. So we have Mr. Gagan Deep, application engineer, Materialize Malaysia. And we have Mr. Yogendra Sivachava, founder, CEO, PSD Systems Hyderabad. And the coordinators, namely myself, Dr. Vairavi Kumar, Professor L. Krishnanand, Dr. M. Manjaya. So we are going to give some of the lectures in core part of the 3D printing and the associated technologies. And certification, as we know that this is an AICTE Atal FTP. So minimum you have to get the 80% attendance to get the certification, and 60% marks. We are going to conduct every day an MCQ based examination at the end of the day, that is between 5 to 5:15. And we are going to have a 60% weightage for that. And other 40%, that is a hands-on session. So we have planned 3 hands-on sessions. So with an assignment, so that is a 40% weightage. So you keep in mind that the participants and be attentive and be interactive with the speakers. And I am sure that this course will fulfill the objectives of the AICTE and the Atal Academy to bring the faculty, PhD scholars, scientists, industrial persons, doctors, and practitioners. So we have a few participants from the doctors and the medical practitioners also to come to a common platform to encourage and share the knowledge of 3D printing technology in medical applications. So with these words, so I would like to thank all the participants and the dignitaries to the dais. So now we would like to welcome our chief guest of this program. So Professor N.V. Raman Rao Garu, the director of NIT Warangal, and he is the chief guest of this program. So we welcome you, sir, for this inaugural function. So coming to Professor N.V. Rao Garu, just a brief bio data of him for the sake of people, of the participants who came from the various parts of the country. So Professor N.V. Raman Rao Garu, earlier he worked as a rector and professor of civil engineering department at JNTU Hyderabad before joining as a director NIT Warangal. He did his BE in civil engineering from Usmania University, M.Tech from IIT Delhi, PhD and postdoctoral work from University of Wales, UK. He has held several administrative posts as registrar at JNTU University Hyderabad, Pukatpalli, from 2012 to 2015. As a principal, and he, that is between 2008 to 2011, and he is also Bureau of Industrial Consultancy Services, Hyderabad, from 2003 to 2006. As a coordinator, Entrepreneurship Development Cell, JNTU University, Hyderabad, from 2002 to 2004. He has edited 3 textbooks and published over 137 papers in international and conferences. He had organized 12 conferences, workshops, delivered more than 100 lectures. He has guided more than 50 M.Techs and 8 PhDs, and guiding at present several PhDs. She has been nominated as an expert committee member constituted by UGC for grant of autonomous status to various technical institutions. She has been subject committee member of Telangana State Public Service Commission. He is a member of Telangana State Pollution Control Board, expert committee member of Telangana State Power Generation Corporation, has been the convener of MSET for more than 6 years, both combined AP separate Telangana states. Sir, we are eagerly waiting for your inaugural address, sir.
Thank you, Ravi Kumar. Thank you for the nice introduction. Distinguished head of the department, Professor Adepu Kumar, the coordinators of this Atal FDP on medical application of 3D printing, Professor Ravi Kumar, Dr. Manjaya, and Professor Krishnanand, and other participants from all over the country, and my colleagues who are actually being a part of this inaugural function. At the outset, let me congratulate the organizers for organizing a very interesting topic. A very interesting topic of 3D printing, which you know that has been a thrust area, and now we can find application of 3D printing almost in every branch of engineering and medicine. And this is one area where medical and engineering are joined hands to develop the latest technologies and see that the patients get benefited to the largest extent. Apart from this, I'm very happy to inform you that NIT Warangal has been rated very high in the academic circles in terms of teaching and learning, and we have been regularly conducting several FDPs for the benefit of faculty members throughout the country. In fact, currently we have 3 major institutes: the Center for Continuing Education, then we have the Teaching Learning Center sanctioned by the Ministry of Education, Government of India, and then we also have the E and ICT Academy sanctioned by the Ministry of Electronics and IT Industry, IT, Government of India, for training of faculty, especially in thrust areas. It is very important that institutes like NIT Warangal should try to handhold other institutes and keep our faculty updated with the latest technologies. Otherwise, we find that, you know, that our students will become less employable. The more we train our students in the latest technologies, the more employability they become. In fact, I would also like to share that NIT Warangal has been very active in teaching, research and consultancy. We would like to also invite collaborations from you and also enter into MOU with institutes for joint research projects. Apart from this, I'm very glad to note that the organizers have taken enough care to get experts from industry, from academia, and also put hands-on experience, which is very good. You know, unless you know the famous saying by Confucius, I hear, I I remember, I forget. I do understand. So unless you do things, you'll not understand. And it's very interesting that they have done virtual through some softwares, open source softwares. They are trying to simulate hands-on experience, which is a very good thing. For this, I would like to congratulate the organizers, the head of department, other faculty members who are a part of this teaching learning on 3D printing. In fact, I would also like to invite you to our institute. Recently, we have established the Siemens Center of Excellence for Manufacturing, and Avi Kumar is also very actively participating there. Apart from that, we also have Hitachi ABB Center for Excellence on Smart Grid Technology. So NIT Warangal is trying to constantly give thrust to academic programs with industry, and this is one area where industry and academia should join hands and achieve the best for the benefit of the general community. So with these few words, I would like to once again congratulate the organizers and thank all of you for participating. And I think Ravi Kumar has made very clear how you evaluate the course and who will get certificate in terms of getting the marks, and attendance is all compulsory. So I think wish you all the best and wish you good luck. I hope your association with NIT Warangal continues even after this course. And I am very happy that this topic is one topic where, you know, a lot of research ideas can be generated. And as the speakers go, you should also see, you know, because we are in the higher education, and apart from regular teaching, we need to also do research. And more importantly, we have to integrate research with our teaching to get quality students to generate quality output. So this is very, very important for all of us. And I'm glad that the course organizers have taken enough care to put many of these things into the course content. And I'm sure at the end of the day, end of the course, you'll be very, very happy that you have been part of this course. So once again, I would also like to thank AICT for starting this Atal course. In Atal, it's a very interesting course. And NIT Warangal has been very fortunate to get many of these Atal courses in the previous session as well as in this session. And Ravi Kumar himself has been very active in obtaining 2 or 3 Atal FDPs. And this is the second in the series, if I remember correctly. And he has set up a very interesting lab. I wish and hope that when things become normal, please do visit NIT Warangal and try to see how we can collaborate. We welcome any sort of collaboration, academic collaboration. So thank you very much. And once again, good luck to all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for your kind words and the collaborations, inviting collaborations from the NIT Warangal. We are very thankful to you, sir, for gracing this occasion. And now the next item is the vote of thanks by Dr. M. Manjaya.
Hey, good morning to everyone, and thank you for giving me opportunity to say the vote of thanks of this FTP program. A very good morning to the dignitaries and the professors and as well as the participants of this FTP program. Gives me an immense pleasure to say the vote of thanks of this 1 week the online AICT Atal FTP program on the advanced medical applications of 3D printing, going to handle this December 14 to 18, and it is organized by the Department of Mechanical Engineering, NIT Warangal. We would like to thank on behalf of all the coordinators, the chairman, vice chairman, and director of AICT for financial support under this Atal scheme. We would like to thank our professor, beloved director N.V. Raman Rao Garu, director of NIT Warangal, and chief guest of this program, for his continuous encouragement of conducting this research and as well as FTP programs. We would like to also thank Professor L. Krishnan, sir, professor and coordinator of this program. And we would like to thank also the professor and head of the department, Dr. Adipa Kumar, sir. And also we would like to thank all the external and as well as internal resource persons, those who are going to handle the sessions, from various the doctors and as well as various the organizers and as well industrial persons. We'd like to thank all the resource persons. And I would like to thank also the registrar of this NIT Warangal, Sri Govardhan Rasar, and also all the deans and as well as head of the departments of NIT Warangal. And we would like to also thank all the officers of NITW and the staff members of Mechanical Engineering Department. And also, not at the least, we would like to thank all the PhD scholars, those who are helping to carry out this, conduct this FDP program, and also those who are work and as well as directly or indirectly helping to make this the FDP program going to be successful. We would like to thank all the the PhD scholars and as well as who are helping in this program. And but not the least, we would like to thank all the participants for attending this program. And thank you one and all. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Dr. Manjagar. Then before we start the first session, so I would like to say, ask the participants to switch on your video. Like, we'll take a group photo. So can you please switch on your video for sake of photo? Please. So kindly, turn on your videos. We'll take a group photo, virtual group photo. Yeah, thank you, one and all. Manjagar, it's over to you.
Yes, sir.